Hello, welcome to our short video on how to design a single supply strain gauge bridge amplifier circuit. This schematic represents a single supply strain gauge bridge amplifier. The resistance of a strain gauge is dependent on the force applied to it. As the resistance changes, a differential voltage across the bridge is produced, which then is amplified using a discrete 2-op amp instrumentation amplifier. Since an instrumentation amplifier's output voltage swing is dependent on the common mode voltage, resistors R8 and R9 are included in the circuit to shift the common mode voltage to produce the maximum output voltage swing. These resistors can also be used to limit the current through the bridge. In order to detect both positive and negative differential bridge voltages, the output, VO, must be biased to mid-supply using the reference voltage, VREF. The equation for VO is the transfer function of this circuit. The difference between VI2 and VI1 is the differential input voltage. The differential input voltage is amplified by the gain, which depends on R2, R3, R4, and R11. A reference voltage, or VREF, is present so the circuit can measure both positive and negative differential input voltages. The first design goal for this circuit is to output a voltage from 225 millivolts to 4.72 volts for a differential input voltage from minus 2.22 millivolts to plus 2.27 millivolts. The differential input voltage corresponds to a change in the strain gauge resistance of 115 ohms to 125 ohms. Since the differential input voltage can be negative, the reference voltage is set to 2.5 volts to bias the output voltage to mid-supply. To produce the desired output voltage swing, the common mode voltage, or VCM, is set to 2.15 volts, and the gain is 1,001 volts per volt. The first design step is to set the bridge resistors, R5, R6, and R7, equal to 120 ohms to match the nominal resistance of the strain gauge. Next, we will calculate the value of resistors R8 and R9 to set the common mode voltage of the amplifiers. The common mode voltage is equal to the product of the excitation voltage, or VEX, and a scaling factor. The scaling factor is half of the equivalent bridge resistance, or R bridge, plus R5 divided by the sum of R bridge, R8, and R9. To produce the maximum current through the bridge, we will set R8 equal to 0 ohms. Solving the equation for R9 yields a value of 1.23 kiloohms, whose closest standard resistor value is 1.27 kiloohms. The next step is to select resistors R1, R2, R3, and R4 to set the reference voltage gain. By selecting R1 equal to R3 and R2 equal to R4, the reference voltage gain will be 1 volt per volt, which avoids degrading the instrumentation amplifier's common mode rejection ratio, or CMRR. For this design, we will select R1 and R3 equal to 5.1 kiloohms, and R2 and R4 equal to 20 kiloohms. We can now calculate the required resistor value for R11 to set the gain of the instrumentation amplifier to 1,001 volts per volt. The gain of the instrumentation amplifier is equal to 1 plus R4 divided by R3 plus 2 times R2 divided by R11. Solving this equation for R11, we see that we need a resistor value of 40.15 ohms to set the gain of 1,001 volts per volt. For this design, we will use the closest standard resistor value of 40.2 ohms. Sweeping the resistance of R10, which represents the strain gauge, from 115 ohms to 125 ohms yields an output voltage of 228 millivolts to 4.72 volts. This verifies the functionality of the circuit. When designing a single supply strain gauge bridge amplifier circuit, there are a few design notes to be aware of. First, resistors R5, R6, and R7 of the Wheatstone bridge must match the strain gauge nominal resistance and must be equal to avoid creating a bridge offset voltage. Next, the reference voltage, Vref, biases the output voltage to mid-supply to allow differential measurements in the positive and negative directions. Finally, use low-tolerance resistors to minimize the offset and gain errors due to the bridge resistors. Texas Instruments has many online resources to help you design circuits with op amps. This includes reference designs and guides, educational videos, simulation and prototyping tools, support resources, and search tools. Thank you for taking the time to watch this short presentation on how to design a single supply strain gauge bridge amplifier circuit. Please visit www.ti.com for additional information and resources.